Membership is shot through the roof. People are returning their ballots.
I think every election is the most important one in our lifetime, having done a lot of these already.
Canadians obviously can't vote in the U.S. election, no matter how riveted we are by the campaign. But that doesn't mean ballots aren't being cast north of the border.
Our membership has gone up by over 30%.
About 620,000 eligible American voters live in Canada. But in 2016, only about 5% or 33,000 actually voted. Still, Democrats abroad say they have seen a spike in advance of voting day 2020.
All of us are psychologically scarred from the events that happened in 2016. So we're not taking anything for granted. We're turning over every leaf, calling all of our voters, making sure the ballots are returned.
I mean, we prefer someone votes Republican, but we want everyone to vote either way.
The group Republicans Overseas also helping voters navigate the hurdles to cast their ballots. They say Democrats do have a higher profile in Canada, but they're confident in the GOP support here.
We also tend to be a silent majority, too. We have a lot of people that vote and don't want to talk about it. So
just what are some of the issues that expats are looking at in casting their ballots?
It's really imperative that we vote them out and we restore some order and cooperation and progress to the international stage.
I'm always interested in the tax implications because that affects how people move to the U.S., move here, how we work in both countries and that sort of thing. And my business is dependent on people working in both countries.
While the expat voting process has streamlined somewhat in recent years, the ongoing controversy in ballots and other legal challenges has created additional hurdles.
When states extend their voter registration deadlines, when rules get changed at the last minute, having a larger organization like this really helps to keep track of the moving parts.
And ensuring those expat votes are counted becomes more integral, given tight races in key battleground states that could ultimately decide the Electoral College.
National poll isn't terribly relevant. And so it's certain states that are on the teetering that could give all 29 votes to one way or the other, like Florida, for instance.
Meaning, in a way, Canada could have a big say in the outcome on November 3rd. In Edmonton, Courtney Theriault, City News.